You're listening to Sound Opinions. We're talking with producer Bob Ezrin. Bob, we would be remiss in not bringing up your role in The Wall. And I think we've been talking about some really challenging personalities that you've worked with over the decades. Is there anyone more challenging than Roger Waters?
Yes. Yeah, there are people more challenging than Roger Waters. Because the reality is, you know, he was tough, but he wasn't impossible.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, Roger's difficult, but he is more difficult on himself. He's harder on himself than he is on anybody. And we actually had that conversation during the making of The Wall. I had to take him outside and say, look, you know, you can beat yourself up all you want. I know that's how you get better and that's how you achieve what you achieve, but you can't beat everybody else up. It's not fair. He is a difficult, arrogant, single-minded, fairly egocentric guy. But who isn't? You know, and the difference between Roger and the rest of us is simply that he has the power to be able to exercise it. Most of us are afraid to let it loose because someone will deck us. You know, people talk about the difficult times, but again, there was a tremendous amount of laughter and there was an awful lot of energy and moments of intense inspiration, you know, just like times when we'd be in tears. We'd be listening back to something like that solo and Comfortably Numb when Dave threw that. And by the way, that's a first take. It was astounding.
That is astounding, and Comfortably Numb nearly wasn't on the album, right? I mean, you had to lobby to get that on the record, right?
I had to lobby to get Dave stuff on the record, because originally the concept was that this was really a Roger album, and he was writing everything. He made it very clear that, you know, I could write, but don't expect any points for it. And I mean, it was kind of like, this is my piece. I came up with this concept, it's my piece, and I need your help to deal with the other guys, basically. So I was kind of hired as the go-between, but I, you know, that's not the role I played. I actually ended up properly producing the record, and that required that there be some Dave. Roger's got a lot of intense emotion, but when it comes to the gentle heart of things, while Roger can write it, he doesn't sing it that well, and Dave does. And then there's, when it comes to the lyrical and kind of, you know, bluesier side of things, that's Dave's thing. He writes that very well. So it was very important to introduce Dave to the process. He came in with a song. The first thing I said is, I need a song in D, because we had this moment and we had to tell this part of the story. We actually had a script that I wrote that was based on songs that Roger had written, and there were a few slugs here and there that said TBW, to be written. One of those being Comfortably Numb was where, well, Pink realizes that he's, you know, he's totally lost it. So I said, I need a song in D, something romantic. Anybody got anything? You know, and Dave picks up a high string guitar and starts to play that chorus with an entirely different lyric, of course. I fell in love with it. And I said to Roger, you know, we got to, you know, let's do this, you know, and can you finish this song? And at first he was very resistant to the idea of working on Dave's song. But, you know, we made it enough of a challenge and he went away. I didn't hear anything about it. Then one day he came in and played me the demo, handed me a lyric sheet that said, there is no pain, you are receding. A distant ship, smoke on the horizon. You're only coming through in waves. Your lips move, but I can't hear what you're saying. When I was a child, I had a fever, and my hands felt just like two balloons. Now I have that feeling once again. This is not me, you would not understand. But I have become Comfortably Numb, and I'm like, oh my
God.
God, I almost fell on the floor. This is genius.